Our host joining me today is BizSmart founder Kevin Brent. Thank you, Kevin. Over to you.
Thank you, Caroline, and good morning. So we're going to be talking about hedgehogs today. So what's that got to do with business, you say? Well, if you've been following the last couple of webinars that I've been doing around core ideology and envisioned future, then you've got an idea. And if you've been following through on some of those exercises as well, then fantastic. And you've probably got yourselves a really good, powerful vision that that you've got the rest of the team bought into and galvanized around. If not, then it might be worth having a quick look back at those and just having a refresh of that side of things. But hopefully, we've started to think about the common set of core values, the core purpose, and the direction that we're trying to head through to. So even if you've done that, we're still in the realms of really it being a wish. We haven't yet got a plan, and we haven't really got a real focus on what we're doing. We've got an overall core ideology, an overall view of where we're trying to get to in 10 or 15 years' time. So we've got to start to think about how we're going to make that happen. And this webinar is just the next small step in that direction. It's certainly not going to cover everything, but it's the next small step in that. But it is a really important step. So to be able to do that, we need to make sure that we find the right business model. And a big part of that is focus. And most of the business owners that we work with are not short of ideas as to things that they could do, ways that they could grow. And in fact, quite the opposite. Most have got so many ideas that they're struggling to find the one that's really going to make the biggest difference. So what we want to try and do is to focus down onto products and services that we can become known for doing brilliantly, really, really well, but also ones that will have the ability to scale. It's no good trying to focus down on something that really is always just going to take up our time as the owner and we're not going to be able to get other people involved. So if we want to build the kind of business that doesn't require us as the business owner to be involved in every single decision and every single step, then we've got to focus on products and services that are scalable. So I'm going to introduce to you a concept here that we will come back to over the next couple of webinars that I'll do, but we'll start it now and you'll get a really good idea and you may well be able to complete it from this webinar, but probably what you'll want to do is just to bring in a few other considerations maybe from subsequent webinars. It's called the Hedgehog Principle. So let me explain. If you imagine a hedgehog being hunted by a fox, the hedgehog has been around as a species for something like 15 million years apparently, and it's got one big idea when it comes to protecting itself from the fox, and that is that whenever the fox comes close, it curls up into a ball, as we all know, and sticks its spines out that form an impenetrable barrier to the fox. And it does that every single time. And it does it very, very well. And it doesn't try something different one time. It doesn't think, oh, I wonder, you know, maybe I can outrun it today. I'll try and see if I can scarp around the back of the shed or something and hide. It sticks to the thing that it knows that it is great at and that it has perfected. And it knows that the fox will eventually get bored. And then when it does, the hedgehog can go about its business safe and sound. So that's the hedgehog, but what's that got to do with business and our planning? Well, simply put, we need to find our hedgehog in business. And businesses that do, that really are clear about their hedgehog, stand the greatest chance of long-term success and in becoming great businesses overall. So, you know, this comes from work by Jim Collins, and he proposed a really simple model, just these three circles, to enable businesses to find and to articulate their hedgehog. And it's based on these three things. Firstly, what are we passionate about? Secondly, what can we be the best at? And the third circle there, what is our profit engine, or the handle that we can crank, if you like, to really drive the profits within our business? How do we make the money? And the sweet spot, our hedgehog really, if you like, is where these three circles interlock. And if we've done that well, then that should link directly to our stretch goal. So let's have a look at these just in a little bit in detail. So the first, then hopefully we've done already, certainly if we've acted on some of the webinars that we've done before, we've defined our core purpose, you know, what we're passionate about, the reason that we get out of bed every morning, the reason that we have built our businesses, the reason why we do it should be our core purpose. So hopefully that one we've done already. So the next two we'll be able to come back to in even more detail when we look more about scalability and value. But I'm going to give you an example now as to what we're after with these two other circles. So let's take the example of a nationwide pharmacy chain dispensing medicines and health and wellness type products and services. So what they might be passionate about is, or our core purpose, if it's us in this case, might be to help people to get, stay and live well. That might be their stated core reason that they're in business, the why that they are in business. So that's that side of things. Then the second circle, well, what we might think that we can build differentiation on from our competition and what we think that we can be the best at might be, we might feel that we can be the best on the high street dispenser of medications from that convenience point of view. So we're taking that positioning about us being on the high street and being a convenient place to go to get your health and wellness type medication. So that might be, for example, what we feel is what we can be the best at. And then if we look at our profit engine, we might work out from that our profit engine really is the profit per customer visit that we're after here. So if you think about that with many pharmacies, if they get the footfall within the store, then there's all sorts of other things that they will be able to sell to that customer on top of that. So they're maximizing the profit per customer. And this gives us, if you think about it in this example, this gives us a real clarity and focus, because if we've agreed that this is our focus as a business, then everything that we should do within that business should be about driving that profit per customer visit. So we're going to be trying to increase the number of customers, driving them into the store. So we're going to want to have activities that do that in the first place. But then we're going to be looking at ensuring that we make the most profit from each customer. So we're going to be looking at ways that we can upsell perhaps other things, upsell other services and products to the people coming into the store. So it gives us a real handle, if you like, that we can turn, but also something that we can see as our base that we can then add things to that will allow us to drive the most profit from that customer. And it's all under the umbrella of trying to be the best on the high street and provide that convenience. And we know that our core purpose at the end of the day, going backwards up the circles, is to help people get, stay and live well. And it all ties in really well together. So we've got a really simple, in three little sentences, really three circles, we've defined really what our business is about. So hopefully you're already starting to think about your circles from your business point of view, and you should be able to certainly complete that top one. You should be able to have a really good idea at penciling in what you can be the best at. And if you think about that, what we want here is ideally, yes, that we can be absolutely the best and nobody can touch us. But even if we're talking about being really, really good at one of the best, either in our area or our field, whatever it might be that's relevant to your business, but what can you hand on heart say that you can be the best at or really, really good at? And then start to try and think about, okay, well, if that's the case, what is the handle that we're going to turn? What is it that's going to make that difference? So in this case with the pharmacy, it was the profit per customer visit. With some businesses that you may have, it may be some kind of installed user base from which you can sell other things, which is similar in a way to that, but it won't always be about that. There may be some specific things that are the key driver of what will enable you to then deliver maybe other services and products on top of those. But what is the core thing that if you get that right and you push forward with all your might, if you like, on that, that other things will follow and that you will be able to drive the profits in your business and that will have the most impact on your bottom line. So, as I said, we're going to come back to some of these in and some more ideas in a couple of other webinars, just to help to make sure that what we do choose as our profit engine and as a thing that we're going to be the best at really do fit within the model of being able to be scalable, because it would be possible from what we just talked about now to find something that perhaps is a bit over reliant on us as an individual. We might still be the best at it and it might be a hand that we're going to turn or want to turn, but we've got to make sure that we can scale these. So we'll come back in a couple of other sessions and look at a couple of principles of that. But for now, if you'd like an exercise to do to help to implement this, then really it's simple. I mean, just get your team together, whoever you think is appropriate within your business to do it. And brainstorm these circles. If you haven't yet done your core purpose, then fantastic. Refer back to previous webinar on core purpose and do that 5 whys exercise. But brainstorm using flip charts, get that core purpose that you all agree with. Then think about your what can we be the best at. Work that through and think about that from the point of view as trying to think about not only is that, so think about the products and services and the things that you do. Think about what is attractive, what you really like, but really think about whether you can win, if you like, in that space. You know, so you know, can you be better than your competition? And if it was an evens fight between you and your key competition, could you build your reputation such that you would actually succeed in that? So that's, you know, you've really got to think about that. And then think about that properly. Just do that brainstorming session, ask those 3 questions basically, and try and work it through, but as a group, because it's a really powerful thing to do with more than one of you in the business to just try and really harness around your hedgehog. So there we are, that's it, very simple.
Great, thank you very much, Kevin. You've got a couple of questions come through. Excuse me. Your first one is from Steve, and he asks, when I've done my hedgehog, does this have to last forever?
Okay, so good question. So we've come, certainly when we looked at the core purpose and things like that, the core ideology, I was saying those are things that will ideally last forever, whereas things like your envisioned future are more of a medium-term time frame, typically 10, 15 years, something like that. And if you notice, your hedgehog has got a mix of those things. So the core purpose bit of it really ought to last forever. That should be something that once you've set and you've got it right, that is defined. What you can be the best at, that may well be long term, but that's probably more likely to be your envisioned future. That's your 10 to 15 year horizon. So that's something you're going to really build up. You will come and revisit that regularly, ideally annually, but that's probably going to stay pretty much the same. But your profit engine is something that, again, that might be more of a, that might be a shorter term, sort of 3-year plan type thing, because what might happen, depending on how that goes, is that you might want to revisit that. So the short answer is no, it doesn't last forever. It needs to be reviewed and then each year decide on whether that is still valid. But equally, it's not a 5-minute thing. It's not something that we do every month and that we change every month. It's something that we would certainly look at setting and having a really good go at over a year. If we find that profit engine, that handle that we've decided is going to be the real driver, you know, maybe it's a particular type of training course or something like that, that we say, actually, you know what, if we were to really focus on those and we got people through the door on that training course, that actually then they would go on to some of our other products and services. If we focus on that for a year, give it a really good go, and it's just not quite delivering what we thought it would, then we might well shift that profit engine. So there you are. Hopefully that answers that question.
Okay, thank you very much. Your next question is from Sam, and she asks, can I have a little more information? How do I work out what goes into the second circle?
Okay, yeah, so I'm probably just talking over that quickly at the end there. But in that second circle, you'll have a really good idea about it from obviously what you think you're good at and why people are choosing you for your growth as a business over your competition. So you'll have an intuitive idea clearly anyway. And also, if you've done that core values exercise, then you will also have teased out some of these things from that as to what makes you different. And really that, what we're trying to do in that second circle is combine some of the things that make us different with our core purpose, but things that we can then say, actually, you know what, if we really worked hard at that, could we create such a, even if we haven't necessarily got it right now, but could we create such a reputation for being really great at that, that actually it would give us a differentiation advantage? So it's thinking around those things. But if you list out simply all the products and services, the things that you do, and then you go, well, you know, and have a way of looking at it and going, actually, are these attractive? Are these profitable? Are these things we like to do, et cetera, et cetera? And then kind of on another axis, you say, are we likely to be able to win? Are we advantaged over our competition with these? You know, so is that one that not only is it a really attractive looking market that we think is a great one to pursue, but also we've got a chance of, we are already maybe advantaged, but we've got a chance of even growing even more that competition, that competitive advantage, then you can actually start to rank some of your products and services and get a real good flavor as to what it is that you can be the best at. So try that sort of exercise, and that should get you there. And it should then get, once you've started to think down those lines, that should help you to then think about, okay, well, if that is really what we're going to build our reputation for, what we are, what could we do that would enhance that even more? So it should, again, really start to help you focus about things that you're going to do over the next few years.
Okay, thank you. Another question that's come through, this one's from Sarah, and she says, does this mean I should only do one thing, i.e. the profit engine?
Okay, with the profit engine, so, I mean, focus is around trying to get down to a focus. It doesn't, you know, certainly for not doing too many things. And that might make us think, okay, we're just going to do the one thing. Now, it's not necessarily quite like that. There will be some businesses where actually that is true. You know, we are really just going to focus on this one thing, and that's that. That is the key driver in itself. As you saw from the pharmacy example, then although they've recognized that the profit engine is the profit per customer visit, so they haven't just said the number of customers that come into the store, they've said the profit per customer coming into the store. Now that means that you would then think of a whole range of other services that you might do around that, because the question that it would immediately throw open is, okay, well, how do we make the most profit out of each customer that comes in the store? So you would then be able to start to think about and put in place a program of activities that will enable you to drive that profitability. So one of those I've mentioned, of course, would be upselling. So what additional products and services could you do with that, and how could we make sure that they happen? You would also talk about the cost side of things, but there would be a whole range of things, and you might bring in a brand new range of services. So it's not necessarily focusing on one product or one service, but it is giving you the clarity of focus in terms of, this is what is going to drive the profits within our business. This is the key, most important thing. So we've got to get that right before we can then start playing around the edges with some other things. So hopefully that answers the question.
Great. Thank you very much, Kevin, for hosting today's webinar. I will be sending out a copy of the presentation and contact details out to you all very shortly. So please do contact Kevin direct if you have any further questions. Before we close, just a quick reminder, if you would like to keep up to date on our latest webinars, then please make sure you follow us on SlideShare or subscribe to our YouTube channel.